Welcome back again in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how I create this futuristic text effect, and its fully editable vector. As usual, we start with the appearance panel to add some stroke and fill to the text. I've made some tutorials about editable vector effects on this channel. You can watch them all in the playlist that I've made on the card in the corner of the video, or you can find the link in the description. Okay, without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. Create a document with a size of 1920 by 1080 pixel, with RGB color mode. Many viewers failed to follow what I did in the previous video, because they did not use RGB color mode. So if you want to get results like I did in this video, then you have to use RGB color mode. First, we start with the background, a simple background I think. Before we go any further, as usual I have prepared three colors that I will use. The first color is for the background color, and the rest is for the text. And to make it easier for us to work on the effect using these two colors, we must first add these two colors to the swatches. Open the swatches panel in the window menu. Choose both of these colors. And in the swatches panel, click the new color group button. Just click OK, or you can give it a name. And here are the two colors. For now, just close this swatches panel. Back to the background, create a rectangle using the rectangle tool. Make the rectangle according to the size of the artboard. After that, use the eyedropper tool in the toolbar and take a sample of the background color. And just like that, we're done with the background. It looks very simple and very clean. For now it's just like that, but I'll show you how I add an abstract background element at the end of the video, after I'm done with the text effect, so watch this tutorial till the end. Next, we are going to create the futuristic text effect. First, create the text. This text effect is more suitable for short and bold title designs, so for the font I used Montserrat Black, with a size of 435 points. Now it's time to open the appearance panel. If you are new to the appearance panel, you can find it in the window menu. I think most of you are already familiar with this appearance panel if you have watched some of my previous videos. I explained a lot about this appearance there. Okay, back to the text. The first thing we're going to do with this appearance panel is to remove the default color for this text, by double-clicking on this character's layer. In here, we just need to open the layer fill swatches panel, and give it a none color. And that's it. Now we go back to the main appearance by simply clicking on this top layer. Here we will find nothing but the character layer we just opened, and the opacity layer. But these two layers are nothing if we haven't added a fill, or stroke layer. So click on the Add New Stroke button, because we will be working on the stroke first. Once clicked, the fill layer will automatically appear, but just ignore it for now. Let's focus on this stroke first. Change the color of this stroke by clicking on the drop-down menu of this swatches panel. After that, select the red color in the color group that we previously created. Next, increase the stroke weight to 4 points. It still looks stiff and looks formal, so I want to make it a little more varied in its stroke weight. Click this stroke text on this layer, it will open the stroke panel. Next, in the profile section at the bottom, change the profile width to width profile 1. And now, we've got this stroke width a little more varied. Next, add a new stroke below the existing stroke layer. Before clicking the Add New Stroke button, first, select the fill layer so that the new stroke layer will be above this fill layer. Then click the Add New Stroke button. This new stroke layer will still be red. I've only increased its stroke weight to 14 points. And also change the profile width to profile 1. We see that this new layer is too thick to cover the first stroke, and even though this stroke is at the bottom, but the first stroke remains invisible because it has the same color, so we have to reduce the opacity a little bit by 50%. And we've finished the basic shape of this futuristic editable text. Next, we are going to add a few more layers, and the next layer is still a stroke layer. Select the fill layer first. Then click Add New Stroke. For this new stroke layer, I will give it a transform effect first. Click Add New Effect. Distort and Transform. Transform. In this transform panel, just change the horizontal move to minus 20 pixels, so that the stroke layer is shifted by 20 pixels to the left. Next, change the angle to 2 degrees. And click OK. Now we can see this layer rotated 2 degrees so we can see it more clearly. I'm going to lower the stroke weight to 5 pixels. Then for the color, I will give it a gradient color so it will look different from the other strokes. Make sure this stroke layer is still selected, and just open the gradient panel. Just click this gradient annotator to apply this gradient color to the stroke. First, change the angle to 90 degrees. Double-click the left or white color stop to open the swatches panel from there. And choose red in the color group that we created at the beginning of the video. And for the other color stop, choose blue. And we're done with this gradient stroke color. Back to the appearance panel. Click this text stroke to open the stroke panel. Also change the profile width to profile 2. Add one more stroke layer below it. But this time we don't need to create it from scratch by clicking add new stroke. Instead we just need to duplicate this stroke layer. Select this stroke layer. Then click duplicate selected item, which is below here. Select this new stroke layer. Lower the stroke weight to 2 pixels. And for the colors, I'm still using this gradient but going to reverse it. To do this, just open the gradient panel, but first make sure that this stroke layer is currently selected. In the gradient panel, click this reverse gradient button to invert the gradient color. Return to the appearance panel. Click this transform effect to change its position slightly, so that its position is not the same as the previous stroke. For this one stroke layer, I'm going to scale it to 90% on both the horizontal and vertical. And give it 16 pixels for horizontal move. Finally give 0 for the angle, and click OK. And now we've got a futuristic overview of the effect, and I'm satisfied with that. Next, I will give it a fill so that the text can be more readable. For this futuristic text effect I will give it 2 more fill layers, one layer for texture and the other layer with gradient color. For the first fill layer, we don't need to create a new one, we just need to use the existing fill layer by default. The texture that I will make in this tutorial is very simple. Let me show you how that simple the texture that I mean. Let's start by activating the line segment tool on the toolbar, because the texture I'm going to make is just a horizontal line, so how do I make it? Once this tool is active, left-click anywhere outside of the artboard so we can easily find it. If we just left-click on the artwork area, the line segment tool option panel will appear, fill the length with 10 pixels. Angle with 0 degrees, and click OK. It looks very small compared to the size of the artboard, so I just have to zoom in until this 10 pixel line is clearly visible. Change the color to red. First make sure the stroke box on the toolbar is active, which position must be above the fill box. Open the swatches panel and select the red color in the previously created color group. Next, increase the stroke weight to 2 points. So, how to make a texture from this 10 pixel line? Let me show you. Previously make sure the swatches panel is still open. Click and drag this 10 pixel line into the swatches panel like this. And place it here, not in a group because it won't work. What just I did here is create a pattern from this 10 pixel line. But the pattern we just created still needs to be edited again. Just double click this 10 pixel line pattern to open the pattern options to edit it. In this pattern options, we can give it a name, and here I'm giving it a 10 pixel line name. What we have to change in this pattern option is just this height, make it 10 pixels equal to the line length. And we are done with this pattern option. And just click done, at the top right here to close and save it. Now we can delete this 10 pixel line, we don't need it anymore. Back to the text, select this text again, and open the appearance panel. On this fill layer, click the drop-down menu next to the color box to open the swatches panel from there, and select the 10 pixel line pattern that was created. And you can see now that our text has got a red line texture pattern. Now we just need to lower the opacity to 20% to make it look less dominant. Just click on this opacity to open the transparency panel from there. And it finished perfectly as I expected. Next, add another new layer below this pattern layer. Select the characters layer first. Then click the Add New Fill button. For this new layer, I'm going to give it a blue and red gradient color, with a little variation. Make sure this new fill layer is still selected, and open the gradient panel after that. Click this gradient annotator to apply the gradient color to the fill layer. Okay, now change the angle to 90 degrees first, so we can see the results right away when we work with the gradient. Now, I want to replace the color of these two color stops with blue in the color group, which we added in the swatches at the beginning of the video. Double-click one of these color stops, it will open the swatches panel and choose blue color. Likewise the other color stop. Next, I'm going to add two color stops in the middle of the gradient annotator, which are red and blue color stops. But for the new blue color stop, we just need to duplicate the color stop on the left. To duplicate it, we just need to press and hold the Alt key on the window, or Option on the Mac, then click and drag this color stop to the middle. To place this color stop right in the middle, change its location to 50%. Also change the opacity to 0%. Oh, I almost forgot that I also have to lower the opacity of this left color stop to 50%. Select this color stop, and lower its opacity to 50%. Next, hover the cursor next to the color stop in the middle, and click, to add a new color stop. Double-click to give it a red color in the color group in the swatches panel. Finally change the position to 51%. And done for this gradient. Go back to the appearance panel, and add a transform effect. Add new effect. Distort and transform. Transform. Horizontal and vertical scale to 90%. That's it, and click OK. And the last step is to add one more stroke under the last fill layer, and we don't have to create it from scratch, we just need to duplicate this 2-point weight stroke. Select this stroke layer, then click, Duplicate Selected Item button. Click and drag the duplicated layer, and bring it to the bottom layer position above the character's layer. Increase the stroke weight to 18 points, so that we can distinguish it from the other strokes. Inside this stroke layer, click Transform Effect to make some modifications. Horizontal move to 2.5 pixels. Vertical move to 4 pixels. Angle, 3 degrees. And the horizontal and vertical scale to 100%. And click OK. Add a new effect to this layer, namely the blur effect. Add new effect, blur. Gaussian blur. And fill the radius with 10 pixels. Click OK. And I'm quite satisfied with the results. Next, you just make a different design with the technique I use in this tutorial. I think this futuristic text effect has been completed, and the rest I just need to add some graphic elements, so that the text is not alone and lonely. I also use the same effect on the shape to create an abstract background. And if you want to know more about Adobe Illustrator, I recommend this website to get lots of Adobe Illustrator courses, from beginner to advanced. There are many courses you can get here and they are all amazing. Besides that, you can also get courses for other creative skills, there are many here. The link for the website is in the description. Okay, back to the Illustrator. As I show here, I don't have to bother to make complex graphic elements like this. I just draw a shape, and give the same effect as the effect I made in this tutorial. This effect is also for shapes, rectangles, stars, or various other kinds of shapes. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because I still have a lot of things that I want to show you about Adobe Illustrator. If this tutorial is very helpful, don't hesitate to give a like. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments. See you in the next tutorial.